Prodigal Steve returns with more Afterbirth Plus. How's it going, everybody? We're going to try and get something new accomplished today. And here's a seed. 1K4C FAMH. We actually managed to eke out a win last time. Oh, we have Mulligan because of Eden's Blessing. That's actually incredible. As I say, why does our Apollyon look weird? It's because we have the Mulligan. Okay, that was actually some smart dodging there. I feel pretty good about that. I would like to get any win at all with Apollyon because that means something new. You know what? I think we take Glitter Bombs instead of turning them into a stat upgrade because 5 bombs early can be super useful. I thought we had one of you sneaking up from that direction. Like, just the excuse me, chance of Tinted Rocks alone. And being able to facilitate that with our newfound explosives. And we're not going to talk about that, the damage I took there. That was bad damage. We can move along. Alright, I actually did manage to get an Apollyon win off camera the other night, just for fun. What do you think? This is our secret room? It is indeed. We didn't get anything out of that glitter bomb, but still. Alright, we have to try, right? Think, like, here-ish, get 4 of them? And obviously we're trying for Magic Mush here. Did not come to pass. Speed up, though, is perfectly acceptable. Get rid of these things. Please don't spawn flies, or I'll spawn my own flies to kill your flies. Tinted Rock. 2 keys into Spirit Heart. Happy to have them. All right, let's just go. Not overly interested in that last room there. And this is Champion Littlehorn? This is the one that teleports more often, which is, like, super annoying. Our fly cannot kill that on its own. Good to know. Please, Littlehorn, stop this thing. Like, what's the strat here? Do we just, like, stay centrally located and hope for the best? I mean, we're not getting a ton of damage done by trying to chase him down. I mean, we did end up mission accomplished here, and we will take the HP. And I should have waited on this Spirit Heart because we could have gone to the Curse Room, but a little late for that now. We'll just go. We're actually a decent time right now. On pace for Boss Rush. And I know a guaranteed way to get the new final boss is to beat Hush. So if we're on pace for Boss Rush, one day I'll be able to say that without, like, sounding like Owl from Winnie the Pooh. But if we're on pace for Boss Rush, we're obviously on pace for Hush. And even if you're, like, probably even up to a minute late for Boss Rush, you're probably on pace for Hush, just because if you're going down to Womb 1 at 21 minutes, it's not going to take you 9 minutes to get through Womb 1 and 2 with a run that can kill Hush. So, if it's going to take you 9 minutes to get through the womb, you're probably not going to fight Hush. We'll just take, yeah, the damage and the luck up instead of Charm of the Vampire. Even though we do have red hearts and Charm of the Vampire could be good, I would stop phasing through rocks, Mini Monstro. What in the actual shit? It's not supposed to happen. The little baby spiders can do that. You should not be able to do that. What in the world? Endless Nameless, I'm stuck in a loop. This is a trinket from original Afterbirth. Oh, baby, the goat head. That I still don't know what does. Like, I used to know every item in the game, mostly. There were a few in Afterbirth that I wasn't sure on. Rebirth, I knew 100%. But the trinkets, I was always bad at. All right, so we've seen her item room. We don't have enough money for the shop. I think we just do our boss and go. And Pin is going to get absolutely destroyed here. Assuming I don't walk into any of those shots. Please, Pin. Just let it go. Can we go back to the days where you would kill yourself? Because I miss those days. Not that you're that much harder now. All right, so that's extra card room? We have to. We'll take Sin Robes. We'll take Mom's Knife. And I guess we take this. And we'll just use the Hierophant for, like, no reason. And now we're super on pace. Like, this isn't a guaranteed win, but we're in, like, pretty good spot. We could always get, you know, Pencil Ipecac again and just ruin our lives. Although I wonder if, why would you dodge like that? You know their shots come out at a 45 degree angle. This is not the first time you've played Flooded Caves. I wonder what, Pencil's interaction with Mom's Knife is. Oh yeah, we're absolutely gonna check this. Excuse me? Both of those missed? Well, we broke even on the deal. Retrovision is not bad, but it is annoying. Power Pill. Alright, we'll use it and get out of there. And why did we get a pill back? Is that something to do with a polydactyly, whatever that item is called? Does it give us a chance to get the same card or pill that we used when we use it? Like as a drop? Okay. You know, I'm gonna blame Retrovision on that one, honestly. All right, so we got two item rooms that we have not seen. And honestly, we're basically gonna coast on this run. Blister bounce back. Let's take Endless Nameless instead. Maybe I can suss out what it does. Unlikely, but it's worth trying, I think. That was the closest dodging I've ever done. Like, not actually, but it was pretty good. I still don't care about the shop. And I also hate everything about this room. Ooh, Perthrow. You know what? Okay. You know what? That's fine. Don't care at all. Let's go try and find our item rooms, because I don't want to skip two item rooms, even with Mom's Knife. We are bleeding HP a little bit. And honestly, as long as we're off of this floor and down to the depths at, like, 15 minutes, we're probably gonna be fine. All right, get rid of those portals, take the key. And I feel like I'm finally back into the Isaac groove. And it, honestly, I'm a little surprised that things went as quickly as they did, like that I re-acclimated as quickly as I did. For not having played for as long as I did, this feels really good. And I mean, admittedly, we're kind of getting carried here on this one. You know, Mom's Knife in our first item room, it's like, it's not time to say that I'm the greatest player in the world or anything. Obviously, like, look at that dodge. Now, let's not get cute trying to kill the dips with the knife as an orbital. Just, like, stab them and move along. Or please, though, item room. What do we have in here? Not worth it. Couldn't care less about a regular old brown chest. Could that be a mimic? Could you go into that room and get mimicked? Do we want Lemon Mishap on our void? I think no. And we have infinite bombs, so we might as well roll for a better spacebar item. Undefined is not a better spacebar item. Getting teleported every time we use our spacebar item is probably bad, but Crystal Ball is definitely worth it. All right, so we'll take the Hermit and we'll take Perthrow. Even though we don't want to teleport out of Boss Rush, because we do need to complete it with Apollyon. Bracano. Yeah, we'll take that. Is that another Bracano? Okay. So it's got to be that item, right? That gives us a chance to spawn the same card, rune, pill, what have you, that we just used. Yeah, we want to go down this way. Deal with this room as quickly as humanly possible. Please. Mushroom. Alright, let's get the map off the screen here. Largely know where we're going. Nope, no creep for you. Not today. Alright, so there's a battery charge. Although, not going to be interested in it. Excuse me? What? Oh, is one of the... like... straight shoot silkworms that got me there. Okay. Self, you're bleeding HP for actually no reason. The Ankh. I'm not interested in the Ankh. So I guess we go do one more room, get a battery charge, take that as stats upgrades. Samson's Chain, I'm just like completely uninterested in. And we have slowed down a little bit on this floor, but we're still on pace. Like this is about the time that you'd want to be leaving Caves 1. Jeez, come on. Anything in this? I was really hoping for a Spirit Heart. We could try for a Black Heart. And anything out of Glitter Bombs, which honestly we should be using as many of as possible. Ansus will just use. Two of Hearts doesn't matter. Since we don't have Red Hearts. We're gonna have a deal with the devil here that probably just can't do anything with unless it's Abaddon. But I guess we shouldn't complain since we did get, you know, Mom's Knife Sin Robes on our first deal. The Sun. Probably better than the Hermit. So we'll take Sun Perthrow and move along here. We'll grab this battery charge, go fight our bosses. So we're going to be like perfectly on pace for boss rush if we're so inclined. And I would be inclined. Because assuming we have the HP for it, we can absolutely kill boss rush with Mom's Knife. Like that's... as long as you have a little bit of survivability and Mom's Knife, you can do boss rush without a problem. Alright, we might as well check the shop. Chaos. I think we say no to chaos. The deck of cards is tempting, but I'm not overly interested. Because we already have Crystal Ball, which is like sort of deck of cards, only better. So... yes, we'll take speed and range up. Should not have skipped this. Oh, is this just... no, this is like new pin? I don't know, this is just regular old Frail. It's just been 100 years since I've seen him in his own boss room. We definitely want that. We are very fast. The shuffle. We can't void it unless we pay for it. So I think we just leave and 12 and a half, or, you know, 12 and a quarter minutes going down to depths one. Pretty much exactly where we want to be. Right, let's ignore that big room for now, although I have a sneaking suspicion that we're going to have to do it. Alright, dip, please. How? You are the sneakiest dip on planet Earth. Nope, just gonna leave. I don't care about that money, not enough to get wrecked by a troll bomb. Guys, come on. Oh, I hate these enemies. I hate the jumping enemies. Like, it's not that I think they're unfair. I just cannot parse them. My brain just does not function in such a way that I can figure out how to kill those enemies effectively. I hear you spawning spiders over there, and I don't appreciate it. Is that everybody? We have four keys, so we might as well check this room, and we are incredibly fast. A one room. We can't re-roll our entire run. As much as I think it would be fun, we're set up for an Apollyon win here. And maybe when we're not doing the grind for unlocks, we'll start re-rolling, you know, goofy runs. I mean, it's tempting just on the back of, you know, HP. Oh, Jeez. That growth hormone's like the range up on Mom's knife is actually super helpful in this room. No. No. Okay, we got like lucky there. I made some bad dodges, but they sort of paid off. And the spirit heart is incredible. Multi-dimensional buddy. I'm like, let's just take stats. Yeah, more damage, range down, and a spirit heart from Crystal Ball. Happy to have it. Much, much happier than having multi-dimensional buddy. I mean, obviously we want to try and get as many spacebar items as we can on Void, but I think saving Perthrow for like a deal with the devil that we can afford is a little bit smarter. Alright, I hate this room because of that exact reason. I always dodge down that way and then get myself trapped. And if it weren't for Mom's knife, we would have absolutely taken damage there. Please. Ooh, free spirit heart. Restock? Yes, we have to take restock. I don't care about the poop. Health up? Maybe a health down. One makes you small. We don't want to spend a ton of time here. Head of the Keeper. I'll actually take Head of the Keeper. But I do want the damage up from Champion Belt. And Red Candle. I don't really want Red Candle on our Void. Because once every six rooms, Red Candle, it's not that good. All right, Two of Clubs we'll just use. Give me back my Perthrow. Move along here. Please. What in the world champion is that? Was that a purple champion? Dark blue? I don't know. I'm color deficient. It was a champion color that I've never seen before. Oh, jeez. I forget what an actual nightmare this room is. It's not as bad with the Gish versions, because they don't spawn like the annoying little dips that get teleported all over the room. Oh, Jesus, brownie. Speaking of dips that get teleported all over the freaking room. Okay. At least it wasn't Champion Brownie, which spawns like the drowned silkworms, which is actually a complete nightmare. Mr. Dolly, yeah, we'll take the HP. All in the form of spirit hearts, of course. Because, you know, can't be bothered to give us a red heart. Ooh, thank you. That's exactly what I wanted. All right, so we'll take Dead Cat, and then we'll take Maw of the Void, and then we'll move along. And I know we missed our secret room. That's entirely due to laziness. I'm going to be honest with you. All right, so 16 and a half minutes, Necropolis 2. We are super on pace for boss rush. Like, an entire floor ahead of schedule, really. I would like, and you know what? We should use our Void as early on a floor as possible so that it gives us mapping. Like, we would have missed the secret room, or the item room, probably. Otherwise, like, we have mapping. There's no reason not to use it, like, as soon as the floor starts, assuming we have the charge. Epiphoria, honestly, not interested. I guess we should have tried to find the item room first, but it is what it is. All right, let's not get cute with the Maw of the Void plays. We've seen how that works before. Okay. We'll do like this next room, the mini boss room. Go back to Void the item room. Ooh. Oh, no syringe, unfortunately. I'm not going to take that just in case it's telepills. And then we'll have that battery charge there on the ground to get us through our deal with the devil that's coming up. Because we're obviously not going to Void... Oh, good. Just two range downs. I mean, still got growth hormones, though, so, you know, whatever. But okay, fair enough. I wonder if the more passives you suck up, the more likely it is to get range downs. Because that seems to be the only stat downgrade that you can get with Void. Like, I've never seen it take other stats away. We don't care about the shop, because we can't afford it after last floor. Although it could make something weird happen, probably. Just off the... Ooh, careful with that knife in the TNT barrel. I didn't need to do this room. I'm an idiot. Oh, well. It didn't take that long. We're still going to get boss rushed, so... Deal with you. Yeah, okay, I think we're good to go. Blue Mom, a little annoying to deal with an orbital strat, which we pretty much have going on here, but we're actually just so strong it doesn't matter in the first place. We'll take the Polaroid because why not? Look, we have to take Dark Bomb. He's gonna pay 3 Spirit Hearts long term. And we got a luck upgrade out of it, sort of, thanks to the Golden Heart. Do not care about Sister Maggie, though. Alright, so let's go here into Boss Rush. Virus, Strange Attractor, How to Jump, and Sack Dagger. Nothing's immediately amazing, so I think we just void all of it and hope that it still activates Boss Rush. It did. Okay. We might as well use the Empress here on this room, because we're going to be doing Boss Rush anyway, since we actually can't get out of it. And I don't, you know what? Now that I think about it, there was no reason for us to take the Sun card. We don't have red hearts to restore with it, and we already have mapping by way of Crystal Ball. So get out of here, Blastocyst. You've already ruined one of my runs. And there was another update this morning before I started playing, or started recording. So maybe they finally took that god-awful Blastocyst room out? Like, maybe it's completely removed from the generation pool? That'd be fantastic. Ooh, okay. Almost just walked into Widow. We are doing just an unnecessary amount of damage. Like, Gertie is a tanky enemy. Did you see her HP? Just gone. Alright, you gotta get out of here. You're, like, starting to annoy me. Dark Bomb, please do your job. Oh, Stain, dude. Please. You stand no chance. Oh, these are all champions because we had Champion Mom. That's right. Okay, so we're going to be getting, like, Spirit Hearts and things on the regular, because plenty of champion bosses drop Spirit Hearts. And Red Hearts, apparently? Dude. Dark One. Please. Just stand still for, like, half a second. What part of stand still for half a second do you not understand? All right, you know what? That's fine. I'll take the permanent Polaroid invincibility to kill you and almost kill Monstro. Get a little greedy with it. Get rid of death. Avoid death's bomb fly, which is probably still lurking around. Yep, there it is. Okay. I wanted to get that dealt with before the gurglings, because they're like substantially less threatening. Where's our other boss? Pin? Polycephalus. Close. Second Polycephalus somewhere? Yep. Alright. We're bleeding HP a little bit because I'm getting lazy. I mean, we have HP on the ground, but still. Get rid of Blighted Ovum. Alright, so there's War. Hey, Dark Bomb. You want to come over here and pick up this Red Heart for me? And maybe pay out with a Spirit Heart, not on top of the spikes? Thank you. Yeah. What I thought, War. Oh, Mask of Infamy. Get dunked on, son. That was an incredibly close call with Gish there. Dude, where in the world is the mask? Where do you think you're going? Dingle, I'm sorry about this. Fallen. I'm not sorry about this, you're a jerk. You can eat Mom's knife, and I'm not gonna feel bad about that. Oh, okay. the spider monstro 2 jump combo there. Don't really approve of that. Yeah, monstro 2, I see you. I get it. You're big tough monstro 2. But like, be deceased now? Wait, why are we taking... Oh, we're still on, Whatchajigger. The depths. That explains why we're taking half hearts. Did you actually just kill your ally? Thank you. I mean, not strictly necessary, but I'll take it. Can we kill that skull that's floating around? Get rid of Larry Jr. Locust of Conquest has appeared in the basement. Alright. What in the world? Lingerbean crying makes me toot. Probably should have just turned that into stats, but eh, I'll take it. Sister Maggie. Still just, like, not interested? If we could save Perthro for the chest, so much the better. And we actually do have to go pretty quick now. To get Hush, because we did boss rush. And that took, you know, 4 minutes of our time. Which you're just never gonna get back. Please. Sloth. This is not going fast. Thank you. This is honestly just what I wanted. You to crack that door open for me. Because I don't have enough bombs to get there on my own. Alright, you know what? This room is annoying enough, though. So you have to get through this floor and another floor. Oh, I just let those two, like, walk into me. Alright, Dark Bomb is not going to be doing quite as much work for us here as he was on Boss Rush. So we have to be a little more, you know, cognizant of our HP. Excuse me, what even hit me there? There's no way it was that guy's shot. Get out of here. Dark Bomb. Alright, I'll take the friendly spider. Alright, so we're gonna have exactly enough... Ooh, you know what? Yeah, we'll take the pony, absolutely. Excuse me? Very confused about what just occurred there. I think we just want pony instead of Krampus's head, but... Didn't matter, because we didn't get Krampus's head in the first place. Excuse me. Okay, so we can't fly, but it does do the goofy... Actually, this is a perfect opportunity to use the sun card, because we don't have a charge ready. This is why we brought the sun card down with us. Not actually, I just kind of like...
The sun.
You know, whiffed on that one. Okay. Like, 4 minutes to get over to the boss fight. Plenty of time. Take this bomb. Could be useful. Kill the annoying silkworms. Check this room. Shouldn't do it, but I'm gonna. Because, like, again, bosses don't stand... Like, we're better at killing bosses right now than we are at killing, like, enemy rooms. Although, like, obviously, Fistula here is the exception that proves the rule. Because he's basically just a bunch of enemies. Please. Maw of the Void, could you actually just, like, charge? So I can kill this room and get on with my life? Alright, 3 minutes. Plenty of time. Yes, I guess. You know what, we might as well just use it for the spirit heart. That's actually super annoying. I sort of regret taking the pony. I was hoping that it would give us the flight, is what I wanted out of that situation, which I think should probably be obvious. But now that I'm thinking about it, it should have been obvious that that wasn't going to operate that way. So, my bad. That's it? Just you? Alright. No tinted rocks. What is that cloud that's following us? Very confused. Is that from the bean? So we're not going to have a charge ready, but we will... No, we wouldn't on the hush fight either. So we need to do this room. And I think if we're careful, we can probably kill the hush. But we have to, like, not lose a ton of HP here on the mom fight. Oh, Jesus. I hate the stupid eyeballs. Oh my god, and our range is actually, like, kind of ruining us? Smelters appear in the basement. Fantastic. Let's check our deal real quick. Book of Sin, probably not worth 3 spirit hearts. Even though it's going to pay out every time we use our item, it might not pay out with anything worthwhile. So let's go down. We'll try for the hush fight at least. All right, so let's check the shop first. And we actually have all the keys that we need. So we need 4, 5, 6 keys exactly. Oh, we have all the spirit hearts that we need as well. Okay. With Sharp Plug there, we could get up to some weird stuff. Please. Come in here. Come in here. Alright, I think we want D20 on our Void. I don't think we want either of those. Is there a battery charge available? There is not, but we could Sharp Plug. I think we take these two items first. Please, pony, I beg you. Then we come in here and buy Sharp Plug. Does car battery ruin Sharp Plug, or is it actually dope? I don't remember. Okay, double charge is actually great. So if we take this, then do this. I would like to get Humbling Bundle if possible. Alright, so what if we do that? Emperor, some keys. Okay, I don't know what I'm trying to accomplish here. What do we have in here? Let's just take the attack fly. Alright, so we have Emperor Purthrow and Judgment. Well, Judgment's just getting blown up. Hate to break it to you. Right, spiders. I don't know. Like, probably there was a way to just break the game here with this combination. I'm just not sure what it is. I think we just go. And we can try and get some black hearts out of the Hush's minions if we need to, but I'm not going to try and rely on that. Rather, I'm going to try and actually just not die. We're not doing a ton of damage here, but I think we're doing enough that we can get the kill. And it's been a minute since I've fought the Hush, so... Excuse me? Do not think that hit me. But alright. If you say so, Tyrone. Come on. Now you... Methinks the lady doth protest too much with these shots. Look, I see you coming in at a curvy angle, but still. All right, do we have Maul of the Void? Okay, we just lost HP on that deal. Fantastic. Really, like, thrilled about that. Self. You don't want to do 9 lives, hush. It's a bad time. You've been there. You've done that exact thing. How are those flies not actually... Okay, this is, like, my nightmare. Oh, those stupid nubs are actually the worst part of the hush fight. Alright, get rid of you. Avoid those shots. Oh, okay. I'm tilting. Continuum shots, just... Okay, don't stand still. Right there, anyway. Oh, Gimpy would, like, have solidified our win here, but... It is what it is, it's fine. Alright, so Hush has popped back up. We're not, like, that far into the fight to be, like, comfortable with where our HP is, if I'm being honest. Because we're not going to get through this without taking a single hit. Oh, I'm really hoping this is a safe spot. Hush is all the way up there, though. Like, we need to stand near Hush so that we can do damage during this continuum period, but I can't move right now because of the continuum tears. Stop hiding underground. Alright. Is this the stupid laser beams? It is. Alright, we actually have the speed to make this work. We just need to avoid the extra shots. Right, no, get rid of that nub. Oh! I'm sorry, donation machine. We're not going to do this on a single HP. So we need to pick up exactly 15 cents. And then pick up Humbling Bundle. Because then the rest of that money will become double pennies. Dark Bomb. Okay. Just be careful here. Key. And honestly, we should leave the keys because we can re-roll those. Oh, we can't really re-roll them though. Not without, like, HP to turn into charges. So we take this. Leave the room. Alright. Thought that was a tinted rock. It is not. No consumables in either of these rooms. Not that we have bombs in the first place. Okay. Let's take all of this. Then buy spirit hearts? Hang on. If I kill myself to get a charge, come in here. Okay. We might be close to breaking this open. I'm not 100% sure. Alright, well, we definitely don't want... Well, we want this. And we want that. Do we know that pill?
Paralysis.
Okay, well, I guess I should have just left that. I was hoping for hematemesis. Alright, so let's die. Reroll. Did not mean to donate there. Alright, so Dark Bomb is spawning some Spirit Hearts here, which I should not pick up. But if I don't pick them up, they're gonna get rerolled. I'm very confused. I think we're very, very close to breaking the game open right now. I'm just not sure how to do it. Alright, I think we take the Spirit Hearts. Reroll. Give ourselves more Spirit Hearts. Crack into these chests. It's kind of like breaking greed mode. Alright, Eternal Hearts is interesting, but I think it gets rerolled. Trinket definitely gets rerolled. And we're at a Spirit Heart positive right now. Although this one is going to take us negative. Okay, this is huge. We take that, we take pennies until we get a key, open this chest. Take damage, reroll everything. There's a golden key. That's what I'm looking for. Okay, yeah, this is how you do it. This is how you break the game wide open. So we are going to beat the Hush. It's just a matter of time. Like, we have to do this weird shenaniganry first. We want that nickel. Everything else, though, is re-rollable. And basically, we're trying to get Spirit Hearts, Red Hearts. The money is nice because we have restock. So, like, we might as well take Spider Mod, right? Because it's just, yeah, it's going to give us Poke Go. But I think we leave that. Is that a Spirit Heart underneath that chest? Doesn't matter. Reroll. Stupid pony. Open that. Dark Bomb's going to give us some more Spirit Hearts. And by more Spirit Hearts, I obviously mean spiders. Counterfeit Penny is fine, but I would rather the keys, because every time we pick up pennies, it has a chance to replace them with keys. Alright, we definitely want that. Alright. Two of spades. Yeah, we'll just use... we shouldn't have used that. That could have gotten rerolled. Alright. Spiders? Like Dark Bomb. What are you doing with all these spiders, my guy? Maggie's Faith. Not interested. I don't think I'm interested in anything else on this room. Yeah, well, I mean, we'll take Faith's Reward. Why not? It's not like we can reroll items yet. Okay, take damage, reroll again. Dude, this run's goofy. I like it a lot. I think this is fun, but I think it's also going to get a little tedious to watch. So let's start buying items. Black Candle helps. What in the world is that? Dude, Dark Bomb. These hearts are actually ridiculous. Alright, well, we'll hurt ourselves. Top off our HP. Reroll what we've got here. Crack into these chests. Pull out of nothing. That did hurt our donation machine, unfortunately. Okay. I think we're getting probably pretty close to being done here. Alright, well, I want that, and I want the Perthra rune, please. And I would like, if at all possible, to pick up enough money for whatever that item is. Mama Mega. This is... I don't know exactly what this does, but I think... think we should go try and use this against Hush. Like, we'll wait on the second form. I don't know what Mama Mega does, but it might just, like, win us this section. Oh, this is gonna be a long one. I was like, oh, just crank out a couple of Isaac runs real quick. No big deal. I mean, I don't have, like, anything pressing. Like, I got stuff to do today that isn't this, but it's not, like, time-sensitive, thankfully. All right, we're doing, like, silly damage here. That appeared to do, like, nothing? So, okay. Obviously, hey, Hush, pop up. Also, stop restoring your HP. I saw your Spider Mod HP bar going up there. Not stupid. Boss armor shenaniganry. Oh, I hate everything. Oh, I didn't even mention that we got Infamy, which is actually going to help here in this Hush fight, because it can occasionally block shots for us. Save me a little bit of heartache. Look. Those shots that come from above you, they do not actually hit you when they hit you. I think this is like a hitbox bug. Because, like, I never before had an issue dodging those shots. In basically that exact same manner. Get your garbage nubs out of here, Hush. Also, all of your garbage, like, familiars that I hate. How are you gonna summon, like, 8 nubs down here? What is wrong with you? Please. Hush. I beg of you. Stop this charade. Just be deceased, please. That way I can go back and get my void, and then I can move along with this freaking run. Oh god, are we gonna do the void, actually? Like, the floor void? I don't know, maybe. Alright, well, we have permanent Polaroid. Oh, we don't have permanent Polaroid invincibility because we have a red heart. I lied. Do, you know, just pointedly disregard the thing that I just said. Okay, we got the Hush killed. Hushy has appeared in the basement. We unlocked a new area, the void. We got 2 pennies for our trouble, which equates to 2 keys. Alright. What in the world is this room? 2 of hearts. Irrelevant. Bombs. Sure, I'll take them. I'm just going to take everything that we have here. Yeah, well, you know what? We'll take Mom's Pearl. Give me enough money to buy the Mom's Purse, please. Thank you. I'm sorry, Donation Machine. I've been incredibly disrespectful to you, especially because there was a nickel just sitting there. I'm an idiot. All right, we'll take that. I don't care about wooden nickel. We'll take Mom's Pearl. Mom's Pearl cancer, I don't know, seems fine. Whatever. Can we actually get to the void? Oh, we can get to the void. Sure. Let's do it. This is weird. Alright, so I've seen this floor before. Like, every room is a different, like, archetype. Oh, that's from PokéGo. Okay. Which, if you don't know, since I didn't explain it at all, PokéGo is the little phone icon there we have in the item tracker, and it spawns random charmed enemies, which stay with us until they die. Dude, please. Stop shooting so much. Like, just relax. For once in your life. Ugh, yep, that was damage. Okay. Might as well crack into this. Like, we are not, by any stretch of the imagination, unkillable. Far from it, in fact. especially like, because this run's kind of gone off the rails, so I have kind of gotten lazy, which only facilitates taking more damage than is strictly necessary. Ooh. Get rid of you. Get rid of you. Okay. Also, like, our mom's knife goes really far, really fast. Which isn't necessarily a bad thing, but it is a little, disorienting. Even still, like, it's been that way pretty much since we picked up, growth hormones. Alright, so is this actually our boss? No, this is the bloat. Get out of here, bloat. Nobody wants you to be here today. Or ever, honestly. Sure. You know what? Let's pick this up. Let's use it once. We'll get temperance. Why don't we just use the sun? And we'll take power pill per throw, I guess. And then we'll void the deck of cards, which rerolls stuff. I don't know. Like, look, we're in a weird spot on this run. That's a lot of boss rooms. Okay. Excuse me? I'm very confused. Eight boss floors. Or boss rooms, rather. I guess we go fight eight frickin' bosses. We should probably clear the rest of the rooms first, though. Instead of doing... And then we can just do, like, boss after boss after boss. Obviously don't need to go to that room, so I'm not gonna. Dude, I don't even know anymore. I saw the keys on the floor back there. I just don't think they matter at this point. Get your teleport or, like, tractor beam shenanigans out of here. I like that they still get caught on the statues. That's fun. Okay. Took more damage in that room than was strictly necessary. I got so caught up with the one in the corner that I didn't see the one directly in front of us. Alright. Use Maw of the Void to clear out a little bit of space here. Because as great as Mom's Knife is, there isn't... It's not great on crowd control, necessarily. Very narrow hitbox tends to do that. Why are we getting so many chests? We don't have Guppy's Tail. Oh, because we have six luck. Okay. Look, this run's strange. Apparently we can kill our own familiars, which didn't used to be a thing, I don't think. But alright. You know what? Do you just want to do some bosses right now while we're here? Oh, I mean, I don't really want to fight Brownie, like, ever, if I can help it, but... Sure, I guess. Is this a boss room for every floor that we've done so far? Also, yeah, no, just, like, got the mom transformation, power pill, pheromones, infested, actually decent on that room. Sure, yeah, why not? Like, we'll take it. Suck it up into the void with us. Probably should have kept our power pill, though.
48-hour energy.
Okay. That works. A charmed attack light appears. Fantastic. I was hoping if I just stood there, the spider would walk into the knife instead of my face. Didn't quite work out that way. Like, that was a bad strategy, but I'll take it. Yeah, contract from below, why not? This is fucking weird. This run no longer makes any sense. I understand nothing about what's going on here. This is just straight up Mom's Heart. Okay. Dude. Please. Oh, enemies that teleport on bullet hell rooms. Could not possibly be more annoying. Oh wait, yes they could. I remember when Afterbirth first came out and they just teleported on top of you. Look, we don't want Robo Baby. Just give me the stats. Yeah, give me the damage up. Sure, use a lover's card for friggin' Dark Bomb. Give me HP. Beautiful. let's go kill more bosses. I've never actually seen the floor all the way through. Like, I knew about the, Jesus Christ. The different, like, chapter in every room. Like, you know, this room, it's the cellar. Or burning cellar, I guess. Burning basement. Next room, it could be, still just burning basement. But it doesn't have to be. It could have been the womb. Oh, Dark Bum, my dude. Not spiders. Spear darts. Yeah, alright, so here's just regular basement. I don't know if that correlates to anything. This is Shoal? Okay. Alright, so we don't need to go that way. I'm very confused. I think this is fun, though. Like, I think this, this floor and the final boss in particular is actually going to be a nightmare for us. Oh, I hadn't thought about that. Well, so I think we're getting close. So what the final boss, like, does, to the best of my knowledge, it can turn into all the bosses that you fought in the game so far, which for us is basically every boss in the game because boss rush. Why am I even worrying about that? Oh god, I hate this room. Like, even this late in the game is freaking annoying. So the fact that it's like a first floor room. And I know I should get the map off the screen. It's annoying, but look. I don't want to do more rooms than we have to do here, alright? This run's already gone on long enough. Is this our secret room? Hey. Sure, I'll take keys. Yet another boss. Second to last boss. Third to last, if you don't count, like, the final boss. Please. Wait, hang on. This is death in a basement boss room. Look, I don't want that. Give me one makes you small. Sure. Let's get tiny. I don't care about health up either. Yeah, I'll take the cherry. Sure. It's fucking weird. Just not gonna use Perthrow, apparently. Just always waiting for the perfect opportunity, and it, you know, the perfect opportunity is apparently never. Alright, so we got a fat bat. Please. Spider. Oh. Alright, hang on. Gotta sneeze. Mission accomplished. Sneeze has occurred. All right. Another fat bat, inexplicably. I like that sometimes it gives us the pop-up notification of what we got, and other times it just doesn't. So this should be... Get rid of that little monster before he jumps across the rock. Like, I don't know if that's a bug. I appreciate that you spawned that on top of a rock, though. Thank you, Dark Bum. Not like we don't have the bombs for it. Okay. I don't know what this boss is going to be. Okay, so this is actually the final boss. Yeah, so we fought Chubb, for sure. I should, like, pay attention to its shots. Alright, what are you now? You're Pin. Or Frail. Now you're Brownie, which I hate. And also you're teleporting for some reason? Mom's heart. Don't Isaac me. I'm a Polyon. I mean, I know all the characters are technically Isaac. This doesn't seem that bad, honestly, but, like, this run's also just goofy. And I can see how this would wear us down, though. Even, like, with the build that we have. Bladed Ovums, please leave me. And I think, like, honestly, I'm just getting lucky on a lot of these dodges. Okay. Very confused about what just happened there. Alright. That's a very fast hollow. Please. Krampus? Okay, so you're just getting, like, quicker the longer this fight goes. All right. I hate that, but sure. Get rid of that thing. Get rid of this nub, because I don't know what it does, but it can't be anything good. All right, so yeah, Infamy saved us there, and then I squandered it. Bloat. Mega Fatty. Obviously, we fought. All right, please stay away from me, Delirium. You can't switch to Monstro 2 and then immediately just, what's the word for it? Laser beam me. Bloat, get out of here. Blighted Ovum, get out of here. Blue Baby, we did not fight. Is that it? Did we win? Okay, there we go. Achievement unlocked Void. Achievement unlocked Delirious. Okay, well, that is going to do it for this run. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, actually, here, let's watch the ending. There you have it. Okay. Well, that is definitely going to do it for this episode. Again, if you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button. As always, feedback is welcome in the comments below. And if you want to see more videos like this, subscribe to the channel. And I will see you next time.